The sun, beach, sea and relaxation. Our typical vacation. But not this day. Today we are going to start an extraordinary adventure. After arriving in Croatia, we decided to visit one of the top wreck diving spots. It became a challenge just to arrive at this spot. Our site visit started when we woke up at 6:30 in the morning, drove 1 hour by car, another hour by boat, and finally arrived at the most famous wreck diving sites in the Adriatic Sea. Good weather conditions, minimal waves. We are looking for a good visibility and almost no current. An intense briefing was provided to enable us not only to take security aspects into account, but also to plan for our video scenes. We have accurately prepared our equipment. This is essential, as this diving day will us bring down to almost 130 feet twice. A descent in open waters from the boat, passing a smooth current at a depth of 60 feet, unfolds the first impression of the ship's upper deck. Ghost-like, the Barren Gouge, that's the name of this ship, appears in front of us. People call this wreck the Titanic of the Adria, and not just because of the ship's history. Our enthusiasm changed to an awe-inspiring mood because of the tragedy which took place here exactly one century ago. Almost 150 people died here. Because of this centennial, and in memories of the casualties, flowers and the new commemorative plaque have been placed here some days ago. The Barren Gouge has been a passenger ship, a luxury steamliner. She belonged to Österreichische Lloyd, and from 1908 to 1914 she was used to carry mostly passengers from the upper class and vacationers using the Dalmatian route from Trieste to different ports at the northern Adriatic coast and to their resorts, the popular seaside resorts of the Adria. On the 13th of August 1914, she entered an underwater minefield, which has been placed there to protect the Croatian coast. This minefield has been created by the Austrian-Hungarian Navy. An unfortunate tragedy occurred only a few days before the Barren Gouge finished some duties as part of the First World War fleet and was due to be released back to the shipping company for civilian usage by the K&K Kriegsmarine. With 240 passengers, mostly women and children, and a 66-headed crew on board, the ship traveled from Veli Lušin, Dalmatia to Trieste. An enormous explosion at backboard torn the ship's hull open. Within minutes, some are saying within seven, the ship sunk near the coast of Istria, next to the island of Brijuni. Recent analysis suggest that this was due to a likely mistake in navigation. The Barren Gouge is a luxury steamliner, with 257 feet in length and a width of 39 feet. It had a max depth of 24 feet. The ship had three steam boilers burning with oil, which drove the three propellers. The engine had about 4,600 horsepower and its max speed was 17 knots, or nautical miles per hour. After the explosion, there was panic and chaos on board. Everybody rushed to the lifeboats. Quickly they were overfilled and couldn't be released or pushed over the railing. Still, the davit arms on larboard, where the lifeboats have been attached, head towards the center of the ship. A lot of people jumped into the water and drowned, mostly due to leaking and burning oil in the area. In October 1995, the wreck has been declared as a cultural memorial. Today, it is completely integrated into the maritime flora and fauna, an own ecosystem. Over and over crowded with sponges and anemones, it forms a refuge for many sea creatures. The former location of tragic events, war and violence has turned into a memorial of reflection and flourishing life.